Hello everyone, welcome to PSE for Speed YouTube channel. In this video, we will talk about the concepts and step-by-step workflow related to the simultaneous heat integration and optimization, and we will show you the application of these concepts through the case study that we have developed. So let's get started. If you belong to R&D teams or different departments from the petroleum, petrochemical, chemical industrial sectors, or energy supplying industries, we hope you would find the content of this presentation interesting and useful. This applies also to the students and the researchers from academia. The objective is to reduce the energy consumption and thereby reduce the impact on the global warming potential. In many chemical processes, the process hotspot can usually be identified in some sections of the process where a large amount of the energy is consumed, thereby adding the cost of the operation of the process and indirectly also to the global warming. The objective is to reduce or to eliminate the impact of the identified process hotspot through integrated and or hybrid operation. In this presentation, we will highlight three alternatives to reduce and or to eliminate the process hotspot. The first alternative is to consider the process optimization. That is, the process optimization is performed, for example, to determine the optimal feed state of the distillation column or the optimal reflux ratio needed for the specific separation or the optimal purge fraction to reduce the impact of the recycle stream and many more. The second alternative is to consider the heat integration where the stream that needs energy match with the stream give up energy for the purpose of reduction of the utility required by the process. The third alternative is to simultaneously perform the process optimization as well as the heat integration to find the optimal and more sustainable process design. In both cases, if the improvements are achieved, they will also reduce or eliminate the impacts of the identified process hotspot. Note that the traditional approach is to sequentially apply the process optimization and then the heat integration or vice versa. The sequential approach will produce additional improvement after each step. However, can a better solution be found? The simultaneous approach, on the other hand, is able to find a better optimal solution than the final optimal solution obtained by the sequential approach. The theoretical developments for the simultaneous approach has been reported in the publication from Professor Grossman's group at Carnegie Mellon University. PSE for Speed company have developed a module for simultaneous heat integration and process optimization to determine the optimal utility requirement while also optimizing the process design. The starting point is an initial design, then at the next step, the heat integration and optimization steps are performed simultaneously through the PSE for Speed heat integration module. Process simulation and or optimization are usually performed through the process simulator. In this presentation, we highlight the use of the PSE for Speed heat integration module within the Aviva Pro 2 commercial simulator. That is, we add our module as an external tool within the simulator and embed the heat integration option within the computation of the objective function for process optimization. In this way, the simulation and optimization tools of the process simulator are used. But when the optimizer needs to calculate the objective function, the heat integration module is called to obtain the minimum utility requirements for the corresponding process design. The heat integration module is based on a well-known transshipment model. Note that the heat integration based on pinch analysis may not give the optimal value, although they will give an improved value. The solution of the transshipment model gives an optimal solution, which is improved at every iteration for the process optimization. We have tested the option for simultaneous process optimization and heat integration through four case studies: a cyclohexane production process, the well-known HDA process, a cryogenic process, and a cumene production process. In this presentation, we will use the cyclohexane production process to highlight the step-by-step workflow for simultaneous process optimization and heat integration. Even though we will be reporting the results obtained through the Aviva blow-through process simulator, in principle, any other process simulator could be used by adding the heat integration module as an external module to be embedded to the process optimizer. For the cyclohexane production process, the aim is to produce the cyclohexane through the reaction between benzene and hydrogen. The best case of the cyclohexane production process flow sheet has benzene and hydrogen entering as a fetch feed to the mixer, after which it is heated before entering to the reactor. After the reactor, the effluent is cooled and then sent to the distillation column for the separation of the product and the unreacted raw materials. A purge is used to vent some of the inert gas or methane, and the rest is recycled back to the reactor. It can be noted that there is a heater which needs energy before the reactor and a cooler which gives up an energy after the reactor. Although not necessary, in this example, the design of the E1 heater unit could be assumed to have a fixed geometry with a fixed heat exchanger area. We propose the following step-by-step workflow for applying the simultaneous process optimization and heat integration. These steps can be applied for process design problems that have an identified process hotspot. The sequential order of the steps also helped to understand the advantages of using the simultaneous option. Step 1, perform simulation of the best case process design, that is, the initial process flow sheet. Step 2, perform the analysis of cost, sustainability, and etc. to identify the process hotspot, and then perform the process optimization that reduce the hotspot by reducing the cost. Step 3, perform the heat integration. Note that steps 1 to step 3 correspond to the sequential strategy, giving incremental improvements. Step 4, using the same objective function from step 2 and the same heat integration problem from step 3, embed the heat integration problem into the process optimization problem through the module for the simultaneous approach. Therefore, in this step, the new optimization problem must be solved and the optimal solution is found, which would be better than those obtained after step 2 and step 3. Step 5, using the new integrated version of the process flow sheet to perform the simulation to verify the optimal solution from step 4, although the Aviva blow-through simulator is used to obtain the results, in principle, any process simulator could be used. For the process optimization based on cost, we need to define an objective function. In this example, the objective function is selected to maximize the profit, which is the revenue minus the operating costs. The revenue is obtained from the cyclohexane price plus the generated steam from the reactor as an energy credit. For the operating cost, the raw material cost, the purge penalty, the utility cost for the compressor, the energy required for the flux and the heat exchanger are combined. The tables show the price of the chemicals and the utility which have been used. Starting with step 1, simulation of the initial process design, together with the process simulator, a calculator 1 is added to compute the profit based on the profit function using the simulated values of the variables. This cyclohexane production process with an initial design give a profit around $140 per hour. But can this be improved further? In step 2, we will do the cost optimization of the process for the initial design and addressing the identified process hotspot. In order to maximize the profit, we will solve the following optimization problem. Let's say that we assume that the new technology have been developed so that we can obtain a better conversion with a smaller ratio between the reactions in the feed. This means that we have the better catalyst at the same original price. Then we will allow the benzene feed to be larger, and we can also obtain a higher purity of the cyclohexane product because of a higher conversion of the benzene. Therefore, we will maximize the profit by varying the conversion of the benzene to cyclohexane, and the flow rate of the benzene must not exceed 300 kmol per hour. And also, we will add some constraints as shown on the slide. Now, we solve the simulation-based optimization for the defined cost optimization problem. As expected, we get an improvement in the profit, which come around $266 per hour. Next, in step 3, we will do the intuitive heat integration. If we look at the stream temperature shown in the flow sheet, the stream before the reactor needs to be preheated, and the stream after the reactor must be cooled before entering the fetch separator. So, it is simple heat integration between these two streams. One needs the heating and another needs a cooling. After the heat integration, although we save the heating and cooling utility, additional heating and cooling are needed to match the reactor and the fetch separator inlet conditions, which are specified. Because the addition of the fetch energy and cooling medium have been reduced through the heat integration, our profit has now increased to around $877 per hour. However, is this the optimal process design that gives the maximum profit, or can we find an even higher profit? Next, for the step 4, we perform the simultaneous process optimization and heat integration on the initial process design. The PSE for speed heat integration model is integrated with the Aviva Pro 2 simulator to allow the application of the simultaneous strategy. Note that, however, we need to give the additional input information to the heat integration module as shown in the green table on the right. Because the heat integration module is integrated with the process simulator, it's possible to directly transfer the input information from the process simulator to the heat integration module. Now, the new optimization problem with the embedded heat integration is solved, and the optimal solution indicates a much higher profit than what could be obtained through the sequential strategy as reported on the slide 14. The profit is now around $1,238 per hour. What is remaining now is to verify through the process simulation that the proposed optimization and heat integration works. After the simulation, we can look at the heat integration model results, which are given in terms of the hot and cold utility loads. In this example, the heat integration results show that the heating utility can be provided by the process itself, and no further heating utilities are needed. The new flow sheet obtained through the simultaneous strategy is now introduced to the process simulator. We verify that of the needed heating utility in the process can be obtained from the process itself. For step 5, which is the validation, we perform the simulation without the process optimization and heat integration by defining the new integrated process flow sheet and optimal design parameters. The simulation confirms the operation as determined through the simultaneous strategy after step 4. Finally, the results from the step 1 to step 5 are summarized in this table, showing that the profit attained after each step. We can see in the step 3 that the sequential strategy increased the profit to around $877 per hour. However, with the simultaneous strategy, the profit increased to $1,238 per hour. This confirms that the simultaneous heat integration and optimization can get a better optimal solutions. In summary, the simultaneous approach needs the heat integration problem to be embedded within the process optimization problem. The PSE for speed heat integration module facilitate the application of the simultaneous strategy to find a better and more sustainable design. Also, we present the summarized results from other case studies. Note that for the first 3 case studies, we are maximizing the profit, while for the cryogenic case, we are minimizing the cost. Reduction of the energy in all cases also reduces the carbon footprint as well as the global warming potential. Please also view our video on simultaneous optimization and heat integration on our YouTube channel within the playlist Educational Tutorial Highlighting Step-by-Step Problem Solution, where we demonstrate the problem solution with our software tools. Now, we will end the presentation of the concepts and the step-by-step workflow with an example on the simultaneous heat integration and optimization here. We hope you found this presentation interesting, and please subscribe to our YouTube channel to remain updated on the new additions to the PSE4Speed YouTube channel. Thank you for your time and interest on our video.